According to the women activists, the unpaid household labor situation in the country is alarming, especially when it comes to the rural women. They express dismay that these women, especially housewives, are said to be working like machines, but unfortunately with no pay, something they deem unfair.
It is more about how is this work shared? Because as I said earlier, we have seen that men participate more in the productive economy because, you know, they inject more time there. Women are more at home looking after children, looking after the sick, and so on.
The job burden for these women includes washing dishes, washing and ironing clothes, mopping the house, tilling the gardens, taking care of children, cooking food, among other household chores. The activists are demanding that men should be involved in helping the women with the household chores, if not pay them.
Most of this work is actually gender work. It is not that, for example, a man cannot look after a child, a woman can is the only one that is supposed to play that role. Men too can play a role in alleviating that work burden so that women have more time to be able to participate in the productive economy. So we are not asking for money, we are asking about how can this work be recognized, how can it be redistributed.
This was reached during the dialogue between the women activists and the legislators in Kampala today, where the women demanded that the government should consider addressing the prolonged challenge of unpaid labor.
We have an opportunity to influence the implementation plan of the National Culture Policy that has just come through cabinet. And so we are using this dialogue to discuss and raise awareness, especially of the role of cultural and religious institutions in addressing this issue of unpaid care work.
Statistics by Uganda Bureau of Statistics indicate that men spend 5 hours doing productive work, whereas women spend only 3.
And we think that if the burden of unpaid care work for women was alleviated, they would have more time to inject into productive work, and this will have a ripple effect on the economy and improve, for example, our gross domestic product and so on.
Women further argued that household chores deny them social life at the cost of looking after children while their husbands stay out long to have fun with their friends.
Where does the man be when you come back from the garden, simply clean himself, he sits, he's served a meal. He either goes to the community and joins his fellow men into discussing their community issues or personal issues, or he sits in a corner, which is very serene, to listen to the radio.
So we are not saying that this is work that women are meant to do. This is work all of us can do. It is a gender role, it is not a reproductive role, and so all of us need to be able to participate effectively.
With the National Culture Policy before cabinet, women want their concerns on the unpaid labor captured so that women also get sufficient time to contribute to the economy like men do. The State Minister of Gender, Labor and Social Development in charge of Disability Affairs, Helen Asamo, supported the women's argument, adding that time is now for the government to find a way of appreciating the efforts of women and energy.
A woman at home, whether she cooks for thousands of people who have come for a function, she'll never be paid. People may be telling her thank you for the food, webalokufumba, but there's nothing like giving her that facilitation. So this unpaid care work, like taking care of people in hospital, when somebody is having money, they will pay someone to take care. So that person also gets an income.
Only time will tell whether this demand by the women will ever be fulfilled, but at the moment, the government has put more effort in women empowerment. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.